Hello, Achron fans! This is Shadowfury333 bringing you a replay cast of a recent free-for-all game between myself, DarkVortex, playing Grekim in the top right corner. I'm playing Vecgir in the bottom. DarkVortex is at the right, at the 3 o'clock position. Kytin is playing Grekim in the 12 o'clock position. And Stakhanov is playing Vecgir in the 9 o'clock position. So that's 2 Vecgir and 2 Grekim being played. And like I said, for a replay cast, so we're going to be checking everyone out individually rather than seeing a broad view. It's going to be a bit tricky, but we'll probably be able to work it out. So right now, DarkVortex is going for about 20 seconds behind the present. DarkVortex is going for the standard opening Grekim build. He's getting a Faro and Sepi Triad, putting Arcticus in front to block off any incoming attacks, make them automatically attack the Arcticus instead of attacking his Triad. I am going for a very fast depot. Very fast depot, actually. I'm actually, to be noted, this is about a minute up from what we were looking with DarkVortex. So a minute up from DarkVortex's time, I'm making a fast depot. And back around DarkVortex's time, I'm sending out some scouts. I sent out a couple scouts, one to what ultimately was DarkVortex and Stakhanov's base, and then I sent another one now up to Kytin's base and stopped the ones going to the first two bases from going at all. So that was just my Echo Scout attempt. Kytin is about... looks like he is about a minute down from that. He is also doing the standard Grekim start. And Stakhanov is going for... looks like a very tech-heavy build. He has four QPRPs. Looks like he's about to get a fifth, but he has four... he has five! Okay, there we are. It's five QPRPs, six LCRPs. He's not been using his Veer class units very much. And he is just speeding past through as well. So Stakhanov and I are just passwording very quickly. I'm not sure exactly who's doing the foundation. Probably building a very fast depot. Well, he has the resources for it, but he is getting auto defense first. So probably wait until his LC goes up to 50 before he builds a depot, if he builds a depot. While DarkVortex, continuing along his normal build, he has a couple octaves going out to scout out. First, they're going up to Kytin's base, see what Kytin is up to. Kytin is about 20 seconds behind from there, or 20 seconds down from there. He is building a single octave. He's got a bunch of octaves already built as RPs. He's paused trying to set up one octave here, or that's where he is now. He has octave set up here to build more RP, so Kytin is really focused on an economy build, while DarkVortex is attacking him a bit further in the future, about a minute up from where Kytin is about, well, right now, actually, where DarkVortex is. So DarkVortex attacks coming in, it's just probably going to be an echo attack, he's probably going to be ultimately actually dealing any damage, just wants to see what's going on. So Kytin is getting some of his, one of his LCRP octaves is getting damaged heavily before it can become an RP itself, and... Kytin has not responded here that we can see, but Kytin has actually built more octaves back when he is, and he's trying to just figure out how to micro this very intricately in slow-mo, but unfortunately he doesn't really have a lot of units to fight with, so he's got to go back and just keep his octaves up and ready to make sure that the octaves coming in from DarkVortex don't deal any damage. And so right now he doesn't seem to be actually changing that up. He does have a Sepi coming up as well, and it looks like another Octo, but these Octos are going completely for resource processors. No, here we are. Now they're going. So the Octos are all going to attack the Octos of DarkVortex very quickly, though. I'm sure this is an echo attack. DarkVortex, he's continuing to attack, but he's actually going around. Stakhanov is about 30 seconds up from here. He has built a depot. He's building an aerial control center very quickly as well, so he's got a very fast aerial control center. And I am about 3 minutes up from that. I have aerial control center depot. I'm actually attacking DarkVortex very heavily with Zionveers and Zion Terchers. I've completely forgotten the names of the units right now. So Zion Pulser, two Zion Pulsers and a Teth Pulser. These two have skip teleport upgraded already, so they're just able to teleport into the base. But this attack will probably not work out too well. It looks like DarkVortex is much further than the past, and he is actually, from his point of view, he is keeping his Octos here. He's actually going to attack me with the Octos instead of attacking Kytin, and he's attacking me very heavily with the Octos. My Zion Pulsar hasn't come up yet. It's about to come up. Here it is. So my Zion Pulsar has come up, and one of the Octos is going to be destroyed very quickly. The other Octo is coming down, and both of them are attacking the Zion Pulsar very heavily. The Zion Pulsar is going to be becoming a Zion Veer again, which actually looks like DarkVortex is pushing back a bit further to micro better. From my point of view, it was Zion Pulsar died, became a Zion Veer. Well, Zion Veer ejected, but managed to hold off the attack. From DarkVortex's point of view, he re-microed it, so now the Zion Veer is having a much harder time getting around, but it will be able to rebuild as well. Actually, it looks like he's jumped back again to try to... He's trying to fix the battle once again, and it won't go anywhere. He's still going to lose the Octos, and Stakhanov, on the other hand, has actually built a lot of units. He's about a minute and a half up from where we were just looking, and he has a ton of air units coming up, and a Zion Turcher, but mostly Shin Turchers coming up, and a couple Teth Turchers as well, just to make sure, patrolling around, he's patrolling his resources to make sure that no one's going to attack him from air, and he's also patrolling, well, there's a couple of Shin Turchers in the middle of the base, make sure no cloak units come in, and a couple Zion Turchers are, or Zion Turchers going up, sorry, it's a Shin Pulsers going up, actually, to pass through Kytin's base, and so the Shin Pulser has come in, and will be attacking Kytin's base right now. Or it looks like, actually, it looks like Kano has actually paused, trying to figure out what to do with himself. DarkVortex, on the other hand, has not been able to do too much, but my attack was thwarted for the most part, so my Zion Pulsers are not attacking quite yet. They will be very soon, though. I will need to get them upgraded again, but he did delay that attack a fair bit, so at the very least, he held off. Where DarkVortex, however, their attack is still coming up in the future. He's still aware of it. He's still going to try to fight off as best he can, and... Apart from that, though, he is sending out a... Actually, he has been sending out a Sepian... Yeah, here. Sepian and Faro are going out to try to build a small duo next to his third base right here. Kytin, on the other hand, we haven't looked at him for a while. Kytin has been building up, just turtling up in his base, building a lot of domes, building a lot of RPs. Hasn't expanded at all yet. He has one of his domes actually going out. It's just going out to defend even better. So he is really turtling up very hard. And right now, you can actually hear the attack coming in from me. That it came in with my Zion Pulsers. So the Zion Pulsers are coming in, dealing a lot of damage. Zion Pulsers coming in back here, dealing damage to these RPs, and now dealing damage to the Triad. So the Triad is getting heavily attacked, or it will be at least once this Zion Pulser actually starts attacking where I want it to. I had ordered to do that, but apparently it was being particularly troublesome. Anyway, so Kytin is continuing to turtle up. Stakhanov is actually about a minute down from there, or no, half a minute down from there, has decided to send a Zion Turcher around to my base to make sure that I'm not coming up to anything nasty. And actually, he's going to find out that I am advanced quite a bit. And this is probably not something he wants to see. So, I wouldn't be surprised if he's going to start attacking me very quickly. And I can see that I'm getting attacked a bit, but I'm not really too worried about it right now. I'm more worried about trying to make sure that I make the most of destroying DarkVortex's base. DarkVortex, on the other hand, has actually... He's now building Farpaws to try to hold off the attack before it comes in. And... As it stands, my attack is... The teleporter units have come in... They're coming in about... Because I'm about a second to back. And it looks like here, the Farpaws have been built. So the Farpaws will probably be able to deal quite handily with these units coming in. And yes, the Teth Pulsar is going to try to take care of them. But the Teth Pulsar will not be able to last. And it got destroyed very quickly. So the Farpaws managed to completely hold off the attack. So DarkVortex has successfully held off my attacks. Too close to the unplayable pass for me to fix this at all. So Stakhanov, on the other hand, is actually attacking me from his time about... About 30 seconds up from there, he's attacking me very heavily with a large force, two Shin Turchers, one Teth Turcher, one Shin Pulser, and one Zion Turcher, destroying my army, well, my pair of Zion Pulsers. However, I do have, from my point of view, I do actually have an expansion, a small bastion in here, a bunch of LRPs over on my natural expansion, and I'm going to be able to get... I can actually teleport these RPs out, so if this ends up going to hell, I can teleport my RPs out. I can teleport these units out, actually. They already have skip teleport. Well, upgrading skip teleport right now, I'll be able to teleport them out after that. Trying to get Teth Fears and Teth Pulsers to fend off these air units, but it's not going to last very long. And at the same time, DarkVortex is actually not doing much. He's building up, continuing to build up. He has advanced buildings right now. He does not have any other technology. He is trying to take over this base up here, his third. Kytin at the same... About 10 seconds after that, Kytin is attacking with a couple Octos to try to take care of this natural this third being developed before it gets too far along. He also has Farpaws. He actually has Chronoporting as well, so Kytan's going to be able to start throwing some units back in time, and he actually is right now. So Kytan's actually throwing back some units, some Farpaws. So Kytan's going to be able to attack. I'm not sure if he's going to be attacking anyone in particular. He's probably going to be continuing to attack DarkVortex. So at this point, it's turned into a pair of 1v1s. Stakhanov is basically destroying my base. I'm trying to do what I can to fend it off, but he's actually, from his point of view, about 10 seconds down from there. He's sending in more units, he's sending in more stuff. He has more units being developed. He has a ton of units, a bunch of Zion Pulsers getting sent in as well. So even if I hold this off, it's going to be a bunch of Zion Pulsers to come in. And it looks like this base has been completely wiped out. And from my point of view, about 20 seconds up from here, I see this being completely wiped out. And I'm going to start teleporting my RPs pretty soon, because there's really nothing they can do. But I have a second base being developed right now, so I have my emergency base. Hopefully this will actually work, but I kind of doubt it. It is fairly close to my main base. And here we go. My RPs are teleporting over to this island, because it's going to be a lot harder to hit them on the island. So I'm just hoping, I'm gambling that Stakhanov is going to try to leave me alone after he thinks that he's destroyed my main base, but I imagine he probably got clued in by the fact that my RPs did teleport away, then I'm probably not going to be dying anytime soon. I'm not just playing around with them. While Dark Vortex and Kytin Saga, Kytin seems to have his... Actually, he's got another set of units being chronoported back, so this blue time was going to be carrying along the chronoported rivals. So once that comes along, I'll have to be watching out for that. And yes, it looks like in the unplayable past, a Farapod has come in. It is actually going to be attacking Stakhanov. It's hard to tell, but that was on the unit queue, the command queue that it had. And for me, I have my emergency base. It hasn't been attacked yet. Stakhanov looks like he is actually looking around. He's just hanging out in my base right now. He's trying to build up his infrastructure. He's got a ton of Zion Pulsers, about almost a dozen Zion Pulsers, actually. And a bit further back, about a minute down from there, he is attacking my base, just double-checking to make sure that nothing fishy's going on. I actually don't have chronoporting at all, so I really can't make anything fishy go on. I'm not really trying to upgrade anything right now. I'm just trying to get enough units to survive. And Stakhanov, he's about 2 minutes down from me. He has his Zion Pulsers. He's not doing anything with them yet, but I wouldn't be surprised if he was going to build, just give them all skip teleport. He hasn't upgraded it yet, though. It's kind of odd. And it looks like, okay, now he's found my base. So Stakhanov has actually found the base that I had that was not going in there. And at the same time, or about a minute down from there, Kytin's Farapods are coming in. So Kytin's Farapods are dealing a fair amount of damage. Dark Vortex sees that they're dealing a lot of damage, or they would be dealing a lot of damage, but it looks like the damage is being undone or been echoed out. Nope, never mind. The damage is coming in for real. So the damage is actually real. The Farapods are coming in. Kytin has, from his point of view, about a second before, he's actually stopped the attack. No, actually, that wasn't an echo attack. Kytin appears to have stopped the attack as it came in, so I'm not sure if he's trying to echo it out or what. And it looks like his attack is actually trying to help me out to an extent, but it's not going to be doing too much. Stakhanov is being attacked on two fronts at that point in time, but he doesn't see it yet. The time wave has to come to bring along, and as far as he knows, he is damaged by base quite heavily. Kytin is really messing around with chronoporting. He actually has a Farapod come back, chronoport it to attack the Teth Pulsar, Teth Terchers cloaked. Teth Terchers not being able to detect it, my Teth Terchers, mind you. And at the same time, this is when Stakhanov was destroying my base. And I am getting my second base destroyed by an entire legion of Zion Pulsars. Stakhanov at the same time is, here are the adult Zion Pulsars coming in to just completely tear apart my base, try to finish me off. And he, on the other hand, has actually got a pretty well-developed base. He has weapons as well as the structures upgrade, or the auto defense upgrade. And he's also upgrading power, so he makes sure that he can build a ton of vehicles without building too many foundations to support them. Because power is really necessary. If you don't have power, a power resource right here, what'll happen is that you'll actually run out of energy. So now it's a power upgrade, so all of his foundations now provide 15 power instead of 5 power, which means that he's going to have a much easier time supporting a huge amount of vehicles, because you don't have enough power to support your vehicles. And there he goes. It's destroyed my base, so I've surrendered now. And so Stakhanov has enough power to deploy quite a few more vehicles. This much, he has enough power for 57 Pulsars. Each Pulsar takes 1 power, each Churcher 2, and each Halcyon class 3. And if you have not enough power, then skip teleport and special energy does not recharge. So it's not like, say, Protoss in StarCraft, where you need power to build or to do anything. It's more just you need it for special abilities. And so Kytin has, with all of his chronoports, actually quite a lot of chronoports, a lot of units coming in, but it doesn't look like a lot of damage is actually dealt ultimately. Just a little bit of damage, just raiding. He actually dealt a fair amount of damage raiding Dark Vortex's base. So Dark Vortex's third was heavily damaged by Kytin. So Kytin did a decent job. Dark Vortex does not have Gate Tech though. He has the legal class. And he's actually getting not really anything with it yet. He has the units, he has the tribe to do it. A bit further back in time, he's going to be just double-checking to make sure that I'm completely wiped out, which I am. So now Dark Vortex, Stakhanov, and Kytin are the only ones left in the game. Stakhanov is apparently about a minute, well, about half a minute up from where we were. He is focused on getting his army around the map. He's probably going to be attacking, from the looks of it, he's just going to be setting up for defense. He's not going to be attacking anyone anytime soon. He is building a smaller army coming up from here. He doesn't have a lot of resources left, though. He has this expansion, but he doesn't have any other expansions. His main base is not being mined out right now. It's almost completely mined out. He's not mining it anymore. And Kytin, about half a minute up from there, is actually expanding as well. He's floating all of his resources over to the island in the northwest corner. And Dark Vortex now wondering what happened to his expansion. A Farapod happened to these expansions. A lot of chronoported Farapods, in fact. Blame Kytin. So, Kytin who we're blaming, is currently not sending anything back right now. He's just hanging around trying to make sure, probably building up, or double checking what he can build up. I'm guessing he's going to be jumping back to this time to just review what he's doing, because he isn't really doing much. Just seems to be waiting for these RPs to land before he does anything. I'm a bit surprised, though, because he does have the units to do stuff with. As the Farpaw's right here, he's the Far Legus as well. He's not building much right now. And DarkVortex is also building... He is building legal class units, so he has his legal class units coming up. He has Farpaws waiting around, probably waiting for the legal class units. He doesn't have gate tech yet, though. He doesn't seem to be upgrading anytime soon. He does not have the QP to do it. He, in fact, needs another expansion, and it looks like he's not going to be building one right now. I'm a bit surprised. He has a lot of RPs that are just hanging out back here, and there's a nice little natural expansion over south from his base, but he hasn't actually used it yet. While Stakhanov is going to be sending up his units, he's going to be attacking Kytin with... Holy crap! So that's... Let me just count this out here. That is six Teth Terchers, three Shin Terchers, one Shin Pulser, and about a dozen Zion Pulsers. So that is going to be quite the force coming in. Kytin really doesn't have a huge chance right now. As you can see, the RPs are barely lasting 2 seconds before they get completely destroyed. Kytin, further back, he sees the attack is coming. He has another Chronoport coming back to take care of us. A few of the Farpaw's Chronoport back, was the Farpaw's Chronoport back? Kind of hard to tell. He's jumped back as well. He's paused just to make some more precise orders, probably doing chronoports. Yeah, it looks like he is doing a massive chronoport and then reordering from here. And so now we have all the units go back. So all the units are going back. So he has a bunch of units going back this time. Far Legos and Farapods coming back to help his attack. And it looks like they are going to be attacking Dark Vortex. He's not actually attacking Stakhanov with these. Not that it'd be the best idea. Really what he wants to do would be to send units back from the future right about here, send them back to attack Stakhanov's attack before it hits him too hard. Although he doesn't really have the units to attack that. He needs a lot of Sepi Legos. He has the bombers that would be able to get rid of the Zion Pulsers, but he does not have the units to get rid of the air. And the air force is what's really going to be a thorn in his side if he tries to fight that off. Dark Vortex, on the other hand, about half a minute down from here, is just dancing around his units, probably double checking to make sure that I'm dead. He probably doesn't know if Stakhanov has taken my old base or not. And it looks like, no, he's just actually going around. He is passing by my base as opposed to the center of the map, but he's going to be going around to the expansion of Stakhanov. Stakhanov is a little bit ahead of that. He sees the expansion is being heavily attacked. The expansion has been heavily attacked, so Stakhanov is actually running out of his reasonable space very quickly. He has a huge force still coming in. He's destroyed Kytin's third expansion. He's coming into Kytin's main base to try to finish him off. Kytin, of course, does have the Farpaws and Farleus coming in, and a bunch of domes are going to be attacking the units coming in, so the domes have dealt a fair amount of damage, but there's still too many units. That's a ton of bombers, especially the artillery back here. The Zion Pulsers here are going to be dealing the most damage right here. As you can see, the main base is just melting to the onslaught of Zion Pulsers, and the Shin Pulsers, or Shin Churches as well, but the Shin Pulser isn't really doing too much. I guess it's just there for recovery in case something goes wrong. And Kytin, about a minute and a half down from here, he does know the attack's coming. He has a Sepi Pod coming in, he has no Sepi Legos coming in, and his resources, most of his RPs are fairly safe back here. They aren't being attacked. At the same time, Dark Vortex... Well, actually, about 5 minutes ahead, but actually it was at the same time as well. Dark Vortex is destroying Stakhanov very heavily. So Stakhanov has to deal with the fact that he's being dealt a lot of damage from his end while dealing a lot of damage to Kytin. And he's got to defend his force, so Kytin may be saved by this, but I'm not sure. I think Stakhanov's just going to try to finish off Kytin and Kingmaker Dark Vortex, but that's really not Stakhanov's style. Actually, Stakhanov apparently has... Did he nuke his own base? That's a bit hard to tell. Sorry, the sounds are a bit new. They're very nice, but they're kind of new, so I'm a bit unsure exactly where they're associated with. It sounded like that was just the bombers. And here we are. So Stakhanov's forces is coming in. His massive amount of Teth Terchers coming in to try to deal with this, but there's so many Sepi Lego, one Sepi Lego, and a lot of Farpods coming in. The Farpods are cloaked. Teth Terchers do they detect? Teth Terchers do not detect. They clear effects. Shin Terchers detect, that's right. Shin Terchers detect. Shin Terchers are not here. Shin Terchers are over in Kytan's base to try to take care of Kytin entirely. Kytin is getting dealt a lot of damage. But Stakhanov has no resources, he has no units coming in. His entire base has been freeze-bombed. His Shin Pulser has been freeze-bombed. And that's a huge thing, because the Shin Pulser is his recovery unit. So that being freeze-bombed is going to be very damaging. Well, looks like he's actually... Yeah, it appears that... I think Kytin is actually attacking Dark Vortex at the same time. Yeah, Kytin is attacking at the same time with unit 2B Chronoported back. He's attacking Kytin. So Stakhanov is attacking... Kytin is attacking Dark Vortex, and Dark Vortex is attacking Stakhanov, but it looks like Kytin has actually come around to also attack Stakhanov, so a revenge attack on Stakhanov while Dark Vortex was attacking Stakhanov. So either way, Stakhanov is being attacked from both sides. That's kind of interesting little triangle going on there. So Stakhanov just jumping back, very near the UPP. He doesn't have very much left, though. He has, like I said, his entire base has been freeze-bombed. He has one foundation, no foundations now, so he's pretty much done. He has his one base trying to just take care of Kytin before he dies completely. And maybe if he's lucky, if he's really lucky, because the thing is, you don't die until all of your units are dead too. He can actually get over to DarkVortex's base and try to destroy his base. So Kytin and DarkVortex basically become like tactics maps of a strategy map because no one really has anything to build up from. Well, okay, that's actually not entirely true. Stakhanov has nothing to build up from, but Kytin and, or at least, yeah, Kytin and DarkVortex have legal class units, so they'd be able to rebuild no matter what. So Kytin and DarkVortex are at a bit of an advantage, although it looks like Kytin has been completely reduced to a bunch of RPs. This is all very new to the UPP, and they have very little chronergy left, so there's really no hope right now for him. Stakhanov is actually not being dealt too much damage. Kytin isn't focusing too heavily on him, and it looks like this time wave coming in, Kytin, at his time, he doesn't have any units left, except this one Far... Actually, two Far Legos. So if he's smart, he'll split down the Far Legos and start building a new base off of them. Be very curious if he does that, because that'd be the best idea right now. He has tons of resources, but he has no units to build it with. So if he splits down these Far Legos, he will be in a good spot, because no one's really expecting him to do that. And it looks like, yes, he is. Okay, very good. Very well done. So he is splitting out of the Far Legos, so no one's really suspecting him right now. Dark Vortex and Stakhanov seem to be going at it. Stakhanov is actually just passing by Dark Vortex, but Dark Vortex can see Stakhanov coming in, and Stakhanov is actually just going to go for the attack, because he might as well. He has some units to go for it, but he doesn't have a whole lot. His Zion Pulsers are going to be able to deal some damage, but they aren't going to be able to take care of the air units coming in. And really, like I said before, Stakhanov, actually, you know what? No! He got lucky. It looks like a Shin Vir got dropped out of a Shin Pulser, and he's actually been able to rebuild his foundations inside of Kytin's old base. So Kytin's old main is now Sakhanov's main, or Sakhanov's new main. Sakhanov's armed forces, though, are being completely destroyed by Dark Vortex. I wouldn't be surprised if Sakhanov went and just aborted his entire attack, but what Sakhanov really needs to do right now is get himself his army back. And he has resources coming in, too. He has resources as natural. His RP is as natural, but he does not have anything else coming in. He needs to get some units. He's probably going to get a Shin Pulsar, I wouldn't be surprised, to help out with his main base to just completely unfreeze it. And he's, at present, though, getting Teth Pulsars and Shin Terchers, or Teth Terchers, Shin Terchers. Both good ideas because... Oh, he does have a Shin Pulsar. Here we are. So the Shin Pulsar is coming in. He's actually jumped back, though. Not Chronoporter, just jumped back to double-check the attack. But when he was about, I'd say, a minute or so up from here, he does have a Shin Pulsar coming up, so the Shin Pulsar will be able to unfreeze his entire base, so we will have his base back. Kytin, now, he's been fast-forwarding through this, has actually built quite a few Sepipods, and a large army of Sepis, so he's turtling pretty hard back in this island expansion, but he's running out of resources on it. However, he does have a huge stockpile, 1,200, 600, he has plenty of resources. He's got a ton of Sepipods coming in. I would suggest getting some Sepiligos as well, because they're really good against air and ground, but he doesn't seem to have the Triads for it. However, his Sepipod army will be very effective against the air units that are coming in very quickly from around. So it looks like Stakhanov is rebuilding his army somewhat. He has a Shin Pulsar, like I said. He has a Shin Tercher as well. His Teth Terchers are coming in to help out recover. Oh, right. Slight mistake. Or actually, no, they're going to be blowing up his own base. That's an interesting move. So he's gone and blown up his foundations. I think. I'm not entirely sure if he meant to kill them or if he just meant to unfreeze them. Anyway, so he's killed his foundation, so his old base has been completely destroyed, and it looks like he's completely relying on his new base. He doesn't have a lot of resources, though. He has one base coming in, bringing him resources, and about a half minute down from him, Dark Vortex has also built up. He's taken over my island expansion that I tried to escape to, and he's also... Looks like, yeah, he's got not a lot of resources either. He does have his third, has not been mined out. Kytin can't really attack him, so Stakhanov can, though, so it's not the best idea. Also, his natural hasn't really been mined out, so I'm a bit surprised he hasn't been going to those expansions. He really has... doesn't have the resources, but he does have the Triads to do it. He does have a lot of Sepi Legos, a lot of Far Legos, while Kytin, about 2.5 minutes up from here, has a ton of Sepipods coming in, coming around, and trying to destroy Dark Vortex's RPs in the future. However, this may not be the best idea, really, given that... I mean, admittedly, not a lot of QP, but given that Kytin did a chronoporting, it may have been a good idea to send those Sepipods back to try to help, to try to hit Dark Vortex. Because the thing is, Dark Vortex is about 2 minutes down from here. He's fully aware of the fact that there's an attack going on. He hasn't checked what the attack is yet, but he's aware that there's an attack going on. He's probably going to assume it's air. He has a couple Sepis, a Sepi and Far coming up. He's going to send another duo, probably, I would guess, either in the third or in his own natural. Or, quite possibly, in my old main, because I hardly mined it out before I died. Or my old natural, actually. He's got quite a few he's got quite a few RPs around the map. He's really parasited around the map very effectively. He actually does have a Sepi and a Faro down here. And it looks like he has not lift the attack yet. The Psychic Claws are dealing a lot of damage, but this damage is at the present, and most of the stuff is in the distant past, and it looks like, wow, actually a Far Legal came in as well, so Kytin was actually building up some Legal Class units I did not see. So that's really good for him. And unless it's a Far Legal from before his main base was destroyed. But either way, he's getting rid of my Archies and Dark Warriors of Beast, so I've been completely wiped out from this. I have absolutely nothing left on the map. While Stakhanov is just turtling up his base, building up his army, doing a pretty good job of it, but he has a lot of resources that he's not using yet. He has enough chrono energy to use them. He appears to be trying to make sure that he has a pretty safe setup. And he might actually... I'm not sure if he's trying to get... No, let's see, he is building vehicles. Just jumping back. He jumped back about 30 seconds to make sure that he could actually get the vehicles he wanted, use the resources he had. Building up some infantry as well, so he's just trying to rebuild his army as quickly as he can with the resources he has. Kytin and DarkVortex hanging out at the same time. DarkVortex has probably caught wise to the attack by now. He is, however, attacking Stakhanov directly instead of attacking the forces coming in. And Stakhanov, right now, this is a bit behind where we were before. Stakhanov probably doesn't have as big of an army right now. And it's also not attacking very effectively. He's jumped back. Stakhanov actually has actually jumped back to double check he has the army. He's positioning his army better so that he won't get torn apart this iteration. And it looks like the attack's going to be coming in very quickly. He has a bunch of Teth Pulsers hanging out here, just preparing for the attack. Some Teth Terchers as well. Teth Pulsers going down. Looks like they're going to start attacking very directly. And the attack, actually, DarkVortex at his own time appears to have echoed out the attack. So yes, DarkVortex is actually now taking, not echoed out the attack. He's being attacked very heavily by Kytin. He's jumping back in time. Probably going to try to make sure he can take care of the attack coming in for Kytin, because now he's fully aware of it. Kytin at his time, about 30 seconds, actually no, about 15 seconds up. Now sees the attack coming in. He has the attack coming in, dealing a ton of damage. The Sepulchre Leaves are firing very effectively, but he's jumping back to make sure he's caught up with DarkVortex, to make sure that he knows exactly what DarkVortex is doing when DarkVortex does it. DarkVortex has not set up too much. He hasn't microed around his forces very much. He actually doesn't have a lot more set up as it is. And here we go. Here's the battle. So, Psychic Bots are dealing a huge amount of damage. The Sepulchre Leaves are not lasting at all, so everything's falling apart. DarkVortex has tried to build up what he could, trying to micro what he can, but he really doesn't have the units to take care of all these Sepulchre, because this is about two dozen Sepulchre Pods coming in here, dealing a ton of damage. DarkVortex is trying to micro this in slow-mo, but he's not at the chrono energy to do it effectively. He has, however, freeze bombed. He did have the chrono energy. Very well done. So he freeze bombed the entire force of Sepulchre Pods, got automatically recovered, and it looks like the Far Legal is taking some damage from some of the Sepulchre Pods, but Sepulchre Pods have been frozen, so Kytin's forces are being completely destroyed without him being able to affect this at all. So without any far, it would have been nice to have some Far Pods, I suppose, but so Kytin's entire Sepulchre Pod army has been completely destroyed by a freeze bomb. Very well played, DarkVortex. That was incredibly... Wow, I did not expect that to go down that way. So yeah, Kytin has completely lost his giant Sepulchre Pod army that he had, and that was most of his resources stockpiled. So yeah, DarkVortex, that was close. It certainly was. Stakhanov, on the other hand, about a minute up from here, having been completely remained safe from the attack from DarkVortex, now is sending a bunch of 10 Teth Pulsers and Teth Churches to try to take care of all these forces coming in that are no longer destroyed, but didn't attack Stakhanov when they had the chance. So Stakhanov had plenty of time to build up his army and to try to take out DarkVortex because of DarkVortex's earlier attack. And it looks like DarkVortex, actually he's put up ground units as well, but they're mostly Sepi, so they're not going to be that effective against these Teth Pulsers. And the Teth Pulsers are dealing a lot of damage. The Far Legal has been destroyed. Sepi Legos are being destroyed as well. The Sepi Pod is being destroyed. DarkVortex is about half a minute back, or actually almost a minute back, minute down from there. He doesn't seem to be building anything else in response. He has a lot of resources though. He's not building anything. He has chrono boarding, so he could play around with that. And it looks like Kytin is actually coming in as well. And Kytin... No, Kytin's player wave is coming in as well, but that's just echoing out the attack entirely. So, DarkVortex... Never mind, the attack isn't echoed out. DarkVortex has actually frozen the forces again. However, in this case, Stakhanov managed to keep most of his forces intact, and at least one of the Teth Terchers is alive. So the Teth Terchers... Or actually... No, Stakhanov's gone back and completely redone his tactics. So Stakhanov is actually, this time around, coming around to the side, then attacking the Far Legal, before the Far Legal actually has a chance to freeze bomb everyone. And it looks like the Far Legal has been destroyed, so Stakhanov was successful in getting rid of the Far Legal before it freeze bombed. However, it's hard to tell. I wonder if DarkVortex is going to be Nana infecting right now. It doesn't look like he is. He does have... Actually, I think he may be. No, these are freeze bombs. So some of the Teth Pulsers from DarkVortex's point of view are freeze bombed, but from Stakhanov's point of view, he actually is dealing a huge amount of damage. He managed to unfreeze bomb, but a bunch of Octoligas coming in. Stakhanov does not have the units to deal with Octoligas very effectively. He has some Shin Turchers, but he doesn't have much in the way of anything else. He has mostly anti-air units, which was really good strategy at the time. But At this point, he's just going to try to completely redo his tactic, destroy the RPs before they actually are useful, although, unfortunately for him, Dark Vortex has a huge stockpile of resources, so he's not going to be able to undermine them very much, nowhere near enough to get rid of these units that are coming in. Three Fire Legos as well, or no, yes, three Fire Legos as well. So, Dark Vortex has actually completely backed up his Freeze Bomb forces, so he'll be quite successful in being able to take care of that. So, now he's jumped back to about 5 seconds behind Stakhanov, both of them very near the UPP. Stakhanov is dealing a ton of damage to the RPs, but the RPs really aren't that valuable to Dark Vortex anymore. I mean, of course, they're valuable, but right now, look at his resources. I mean, really, this is enough to fund another army right now. So, he doesn't have much to worry about, but Stakhanov does have a pretty large army coming in, and Dark Vortex may want to try to get some of his backup resources, RPs, moved around, because they've mostly mined out what they were going for. Now, Dark Vortex is very near the UPP, and Stakhanov has actually jumped forward to the present, and it looks like Stakhanov jumping back actually 3 minutes, so he's very near the UPP as well. So double-checking the attack, a Sevi bot coming in to try to check out this RP destruction, but it doesn't look like he's going to be able to save them. Sevi Legal coming in instead. Dark Vortex, from his point of view, appears to be he's attacking with his Sevi Legos and not really doing a lot of damage. These are Teth Pulsers, they are completely anti-air units. The Sevi Legos are not going to be able to do a lot. They will be able to kill a Teth Pulser, but not very much. The Far Lego is really the ace in the hole, but unfortunately it's not freezing right now. None of the Far Legos are. This one's coming up. It looks like it's in a good position to freeze, and it is dead. Okay, well, oh wait, no, he's jumped back in time. Okay, sorry. Dark Vortex has actually jumped back about 5 seconds, just double check, make sure that the Far Lego is in good position. He's slow-mo now, getting the Far Lego right in the position he wants. However, it's taking a lot of damage, and Freeze Bomb, not the most effective Freeze Bomb, I'm afraid. It's still in the way. So he did manage to take care of took care of that a bit, but unfortunately for him, it was not the most effective Freeze Bomb. However, it is enough for the Octopus to get in and destroy the units before they're able to do too much damage. The Teth Terchers is coming in, is not recovering the units yet. Looks like Stakhanov is actually going to have a pretty hard time taking care of this force. However, this one of you just looks like he was successful. No, jumping back. Okay, now he's jumping back to make sure. And yes, Stakhanov is going to have a very hard time dealing with this. A lot of Octoligos, the Far Legos as well. So, not the best anti-air force, but there aren't a lot of air units coming in anyway. So, Shin Churches would be probably the best idea right now. And it looks like, I think Dark Vortex actually nanite-infected some of the units. It's hard to... Yes, he did! He nanite-infected this Teth Pulser right here. So, one of the Teth Pulsers of Stakhanov is actually... was under control of Dark Vortex, but it looks like it's not going to matter too much. Dark Vortex is coming in, trying to destroy Stakhanov's base. Stakhanov has a couple of Zion Churches, but it's not going to be doing too much. It's going to be doing a bit if he can cloak them, because Dark Vortex does not have any detectors right now. But Dark Vortex... It doesn't look like it's going to make that much of a difference. Really, two Zion Churches coming in, cloaked. Stakhanov has... Has he even cloaked them yet? It doesn't look like he has... He has the chrono energy to do so, but he hasn't actually done that. So, with the CE, he can take care of it. It looks like he is taking a lot of damage. Kytin, on the other hand, not really been following him very much. He's actually rebuilt his entire most of his heavy pod force. Still has a huge heavy pod force. Some fire pods coming in as well. That'll help out with the freezing if they manage to stay alive that long. And he has actually expanded as well to Sakhanov's old third. So, right now, he's also gotten his own old third. So, Kytin is actually going to be... is kind of sneaky right now. And Dark Vortex has chronoported back a bunch of his units. So Dark Vortex has a chronoported army coming in, likely attacking Stakhanov in the far unplayable past. So Stakhanov is going to be dealing with this. Well, not going to be able to deal with this, actually. And no, actually, the chronoport was an Echo Chronoport, but it doesn't matter. The units are going to be dealing enough damage as it is right now, chronally, without actually having to go back in time. So Stakhanov has, unfortunately, lost. Very well played, though, with the rebuild of the foundations, and he actually got a very large army in that short amount of time. So, very impressive, but really, those Farapod, or Far League of Reezes, man, those are powerful. And looks like Kytin as well, he's actually in the present, but back at that point in time, about 2.5 minutes down, he did have forces attacking very heavily, and in the present, he has a lot of Farapod, or a lot of Sevipods, a couple of Farapods, and I'm not sure if he's going to be chronoporting them back, or if he's going to... No, it looks like he's not going to be chronoporting them back. So, it looks like... Yeah, he doesn't have enough QP to do that. He doesn't have any expansions heavily on QP. He does have... Well, actually, he has this one on, like, 3 RPs here and 2 RPs. So he has 5 RPs on QP. Actually, 7 RPs on QP. But it's not going to be enough with all the stuff he has going. So Stakhanov has surrendered. And now Dark Vortex and Kytin are going at it. The last two players left. So right now, Dark Vortex really actually hasn't changed his army size much. He must have lost a ton of force when he was attacking Stakhanov. So... Right now, he has two Far Legos, two Far Pods, an Octoligo, and a Sevipod. Not the worst, not a bad composition, but a fairly small numbers when you consider that Kytin, it's about a minute and a half up, but he does have about almost, he has a dozen Sevipods at least. Actually, no, a dozen and a half Sevipods. And all the Sepis that he has as well, at least 2 dozen of those. So Kytin's got a fairly solid turtle position on the island, while DarkVortex, about 2.5 minutes down now, Kytin's joined him as well, and looks like Kytin, I'm not sure if he's going to be attacking right now. He doesn't have a whole lot of chrono energy. He does have everything connected to the Arcticus, though. But I'm not sure if he's going to be attacking. It looks like he's just trying to hold up, make sure the Dark Vortex isn't doing anything tricky. And it looks like Dark Vortex is not doing anything tricky. He's just hanging out in his base. Giving my throat a bit of rest, thankfully, because that was quite the battle going on there. He's resting in his base, healing up his units, making sure that they're going to be in good position, just building up, rebuilding his army. Kytin is continuing to build up his army as well, getting the resources he needs. No legal class units, mind you, which is rather odd. I really wouldn't be surprised to see a couple Sepi Legos, but apparently he's completely decided to go for pod class units. Now, of course, if he can get the fire pods out of fire, the freeze bombs, he can actually recover pretty effectively with them. The recover is, like, they have 40 energy, and the recover costs 4 energy each, so they can do 10 recovers each. So that should be enough to save the army if they get freeze bombed at least once. Dark Vortex, on the other hand, about 10 seconds up from here, is actually going for the attack. So he's going on the assault, trying to figure out where Kytin's going. He's jumped back about 20 seconds. He's changed where he's attacking to, but it looks like he's ultimately going to the center of the map. Just double-checking where Kytin is. He actually has a lot of Reese. Wow. So he's got really nice healing capabilities if he can retreat his forces back to base. He has almost all of his tech, though. He only needs weaponry, and he has everything, but he probably doesn't really need that right now. Actually, he could use it, though, because Kytin, he does have a fair amount of forces, but if Dark Vortex fired a plasma cruise missile somewhere on the edge of here, he'd probably be able to take care of most of these Sepis and heavily damage these Sepi pods. Regardless, he's not going for that, and neither is Kytin. Neither of them are going for weapons. Actually, Kytin can't go for tech at all. He has no reef at the moment. And here we are. So a couple of Dark Vortex's RPs are coming in. About 5 seconds down here, the RPs coming in to get to Kytin, and a bunch of forces are coming in, and it looks like, yes, he's found Kytin's base. So Kytin's forces are attacking very heavily. Seven plus are dealing a ton of damage. The Fire Legos haven't started to attack to freeze bomb yet, but they haven't been reordered. So they could very well be reordered to freeze bomb. He hasn't actually realized how big Kytin got when he wasn't looking at him while he's trying to take care of Stakhanov. However, Dark Vortex does have a lot of resources, while Kytin, on the other hand, is actually no longer that starved. He has a fair amount of resources as well, and they're about the same time. So it looks like still no legal class units, but a lot of Sepi pods. And Dark Vortex is actually holding off his attack for right now, probably getting himself into position, making sure he has enough energy for the freeze bomb. The freeze bomb is about half the energy of the Fire Lego. And he is not building up any more, though, surprisingly enough. He has plenty of resources, he really should. Or Chronoport back, either way. Now, Kytin, on the other hand, is actually sending up a bunch of units. He's actually sent out a bunch of Octos. Looks like, did he? Yeah, it looks like he actually built a Faro and a Sepi, or either, yeah, he built, looks like, a Faro and a Sepi out of his Arcticus, and actually built up a ton of Octos. He has an entire army of Octos coming down, trying to take care of these Octoligos. The Octoligos will be able to deal with them very quickly, but there are a lot of them. As you can see, there are a great number of Octos coming in, about a dozen and a half or so. So a great number of Octos coming in, and once these Octopods actually get, or Octoligos get into range, the Octos will be able to deal with them, but the Octos haven't been ordered to attack, they're simply attacking reactively, so they're not going to be able to deal as much damage. And the Sepipods also coming in from the north, and coming in through the forces of Dark Vortex, and Kytin did not cornport these, actually, he just passed them through. Dealing with the forces of Dark Vortex, I wouldn't be surprised back in time he's actually Chrono Freeze, and no, he's not. He's trying to defend his Octoligos, trying to make all this get all his forces in one position, but it may be a bad idea because he is being very heavily pincered right now. Kytin, from his time, about 10 seconds up from here, sees the attack coming in. It sees that as being very powerful. However, he also sees that Dark Vortex has moved his forces from this location and is actually going to be having all his forces in the middle of the map. And Sepipods are coming up again to try to deal with these forces, or they were coming up, but now they're retreating. The Octos aren't going to be able to deal a lot of damage. They're going to be able to take care of the Octoligos somewhat. However, Dark Vortex is trying to re-micro this army as best he can. He's running out of Chrono Energy, though. Both players are going to be out of Chrono Energy very quickly. Trying to micro this force as best as they can. And I don't know why the game is frozen. And trying to micro their forces as best they can. And the Octoligos have been destroyed. Dark Vortex jumping back to make sure that he sees what's going on. The Octoligos are being heavily damaged. One of the Octos was nano-infected, but it didn't do a lot of damage. And it looks like the Octos, or what the, oh no, this is from Dark Vortex's point of view. So Kytin has actually, from his point of view, however, this is a bit up from here, so this may be undone. He has all the Sepipods coming in. The Sepipods have actually passed through Dark Vortex's forces and are directly attacking his base, smashing up his reefs, taking care of, dome should be gone pretty soon too. Yep, this dome's gonna be going very quickly, so over two dozen, or about, let's see, about a dozen and a half Sebi Pods, I'd say, are coming in, dealing a ton of damage. 20 Sebi Pods coming in, just tearing apart the base. DarkVortex, of course, I'm sure, is not just taking this in stride completely. However, oh, you know what? Yes, he is. DarkVortex actually doesn't have really much to go off of. His only real hope is a Farlego Freeze Bomb, getting lucky with that, but I don't know how he's going to be able to pull that off. It looks like he might be trying to micromanage that out. And yes, he's getting the Farlego into the army, and Sebi Pods are not attacking at all, but no, and yes, it worked! Okay, so, a bunch of Sebi Pods are frozen, but not all of them are frozen. Fortunately, it's gonna be enough, unless this Farlego can come in and freeze up those remaining Sebi Pods, and then another force comes in to take care of them, to finish them off. I don't see this working out very well for Dark Works, but I think Dark Works will be able to pull this off. His Farlego is, yes he did! Okay, so he two freezes, got rid of all the Sebi Pods. Kytin, on the other hand, jumping back to make sure you can see what's going on. He has enough control to make sure that his Sebi Pods don't attack directly. I'm not sure if he's going to be taking advantage of it, getting his Archicus to order them back. And it looks like the Fire Pods have been destroyed a bit more effectively. So, second time around, it looks like Octos and Sebi Pods coming in. Sebi Pods repositioned themselves properly, so they didn't get freeze bombed completely to death. And it looks like Kytin has taken the game. He's taken most of the map, that's for sure. If you see around the map control, he has a bunch of... He has RPs everywhere, he has Archicus everywhere, he has everything everywhere. So it looks like Kytin has probably taken the game right now. DarkVortex, from his point of view, about 5 seconds in the future, he thinks that he has it frozen, but even with that, the Sebi Pods and Octos are still dealing so much damage that it's not going to make a difference. However, from Kytin's point of view, he has completely destroyed DarkVortex's base, and this is further past. DarkVortex has about a minute to fix this up, or at least try, but I really don't think he's going to be able to. That's like two dozen Sebi Pods at least coming in through his base, and that's going to be way too much for him to handle. With four, like two Farlegos can deal with it with a well-placed freeze bomb, but that well-placed freeze bomb has to be right next to the unplayable past. Otherwise, it's going to be doing nothing. And even then, the Octos alone. Admittedly, without the Sebi Pods in the way, the Farlegos could actually take care of the Octos. And it looks like here we have DarkVortex is jumping back. However, he can't take care of this too much. He's looking at the UBP. Yeah, he sees he has his forces being attacked. He didn't manage to get the freeze bomb off this time around. He is just reviewing the attack to see what he did wrong. But it looks like he has really no way of dealing with this. Even Chronoporting wouldn't be able to save him now. Because, of course, that would just create a paradox, because that is not a causally independent base from anything else. So he'd have one chance, and even then it'd be a 50% chance, but I really don't think he's gonna be going for that. It doesn't look like he's not jumping ahead of the blue time, which is the one carrying his death. So it looks like he's pretty much just completely accepted his fate. He hasn't tried to jump any units back to save himself. Because jumping back Farlego right now to freeze bomb all these Sebi Pods would actually be a very effective strategy. Provided he had another Farlego coming down the pipe right afterwards. Because then he'd be able to recover his original Farlego and take care of the Octos. Because Farlegos freeze themselves when they do a freeze bump. However, Kytin has pretty much got free reign of the map. Kytin has won. DarkVortex has surrendered. Well done, Kytin. That was a very exciting match. A lot of backboard, a lot of going around, a lot of recovery. My attempted recovery and Stakhanov's almost successful recovery. And Kytin's completely successful recovery and complete comeback in this game. So, very well done to everyone. And I hope you enjoyed that. Very long game, very entertaining, I hope for you guys. And everyone, have a good night.